Sun don't stop for nobody, man. Sun don't fucking stop. Sun gonna be up in the morning regardless. That sun is gonna be up in the morning regardless. Regardless of how I fucking feel and how depressed I am, the sun is gonna fucking shine in the morning. And at nighttime, the moon gonna be there. And you gonna look up, these days gonna keep going by. So do you let the days go by and look up and you done wasted a year doing what? Or do you just pick it up? All right, well, gotta figure it out. Made some mistakes, life goes on. Let me figure out life from this point. Hold on, I still
want you. It's not the goodbyes that hurt.
Come back, I still need you.
But the flashbacks that follow.
We fall in love with three people in our lifetime. Our first love. This love often happens at a young age. You eventually grow apart, call it quits over silly things. When you grow older, you may look back and think it wasn't love. But the truth is, it was. It was love for what you knew love to be. Then there's our second love, the hard one. You get hurt in this one. This love teaches us lessons and makes us stronger. This love includes great pain, lies, betrayal, abuse, drama, and damage. But this is the one where we grow. We realize what we love about love and what we don't love about love. Now we know the difference between good and bad partners. Now we become closed, careful, cautious, and considerate. We now know exactly what we want and what we don't want. Then there's our third love. This one comes blindly. No warning. It creeps up on you silently. You don't go looking for this love. It comes to you. You can put any wall up you want. It'll be broken down. You'll find yourself caring about a person without trying. They look nothing like your usual crush types, but you get lost in their eyes daily. You see beauty in their imperfections. You hide nothing from them. You want marriage and family with them. You thank the universe for them. You truly love them.
Please don't go away. Please. No one's ever stuck with me for so long before. And if you leave, I remember things better with you. I do. Look, P. Sherman, 42. I remember it. I do. It's there. I know it is, because when I look at you, I can feel it. And I look at you and I'm home. I don't want that to go away. I don't want to forget.
I'm sorry, Dory, but I do.
When someone says, "You look sad today," truth is, I'm sad every day. I just didn't have the energy to hide it today.
I'm not angry, I am in pain, and you put me here! The person who's supposed to love me more than anything!
The best advice I've been given, and I wish that I knew when I was younger, is don't be in a relationship with anyone you wouldn't marry. Here's why. It's a waste of time and it takes you off the market. Don't worry too much about relationships. Build friendships, and maybe one day you'll meet your soulmate. Or maybe you realise you want to spend the rest of your life with your best friend. Your life should not be spent on trying to fall in love or having to worry about a partner. Your life right now should be spent on you finding yourself. Go to that party, study hard, hang out with the boys, hang out with the girls. Because as you get older, all those people are going to be in their own lane doing their own thing. You're going to look back and regret not enjoying your life when you were young. If you have a goal, reach for it. If you don't worry about it. The past is a memory, the future is imagination, and the present is a gift. Make the most of being young, because trust me, getting older comes fast.
People say, "Oh, relationships are tough." No, they're not. They're only tough when one person's working on it. Two people can move a couch real easy. One person can't move it at all. If you're in a relationship, let me try to help you right now. Rule one, stop competing. Her success is your success, and your success is her success. Stop competed. Number two, okay? There is no equality in a relationship. It's like, we equals. No, you're not. You're both there to serve. You are in the service industry, okay? When you're in a relationship, you're in a band. And when you're in a band, you have roles that you play in the band.
If you're not getting hated on, you ain't doing shit right. You need people talking about you. You need people saying, I don't like that person. Because in turn, they really want to be you.
Once I was 7 years old, my mama told me, go make yourself some friends or you'll be lonely. Once I was 7 years old.
Black History Month, you find
ridiculous.
Why?
You're going to relegate my history to a month?
Oh, come on.
What do you do with yours? Which month is White History Month? No, well, no, well, come on, tell me.
Well, I'm Jewish.
Okay, which month is Jewish History Month?
There isn't one.
Oh, why not?
Yeah.
You want one?
No.
I don't either. I don't want a Black History Month. Black history is American history.
How are we going to get rid of racism?
Stop talking about it. I'm going to stop calling you a white man.
Yeah.
And I'm going to ask you to stop calling me a black man. I know you as Mike Wallace. You know me as Morgan Freeman. You say, well, I know this white guy named Mike Wallace. You know what I'm saying?
Uh-huh. How to date an overthinker. Understand that they can't control their thoughts. It's not their fault. Be compassionate when you receive bouts of insecurities. They will question everything until they understand. Be very clear about what you intend to say to avoid confusion. They will dissect each word repeatedly. Be okay with making a lot of decisions. Overthinkers are plagued by indecisiveness. But once they decide, you can't change their mind. You need to constantly reassure them that you aren't going anywhere. Never lie to an overthinker. It will not end well. They will think about it over and over till it makes sense to them. And finally, trust an overthinker when they tell you they love you. They have already thought of every reason not to.
If you're looking for a sign, this is for you. You deserve a call me anytime love, a pick you up from the airport love, a love note on napkins kind of love, a chicken noodle soup for sore throats kind of love, a back rub before bed kind of love, a laugh at your bad jokes kind of love, a reminder to get up 10 minutes earlier because it snowed and you're going to have to clean off your car kind of love, a clean off your car for you kind of love, a bring you cheesecake when you have cramps kind of love, a listening love. A love that takes care of you. A love that sees your messy hair, your morning breath, your spiraling mind, your no-sleep crankiness. A love that loves you more because of it. You deserve a requited love. A love that lasts.
Do not come into my life if you are going to leave! Do not sit here and tell me you are in love with me, and that you care for me, and that you want to see me happy if you are going to leave! I am tired!
But somewhere along the line, you changed. You stop being you. You let people stick a finger in your face and tell you you're no good. And when things got hard, you started looking for something to blame. Like a big shadow. Let me tell you something you already know. The world ain't all sunshine and rainbows. It's a very mean and nasty place, and I don't care how tough you are, it will beat you to your knees and keep you there permanently if you let it. You, me, or nobody is gonna hit as hard as life. But it ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done. Now, if you know what you're worth, then go out and get what you're worth. But you gotta be willing to take the hits and not pointing fingers saying you ain't where you wanna be because of him or her or anybody. Cowards do that, and that ain't you. You're better than that.